two, three, four.
Mr. Wednesday for
April
14th. April 14th, second Wednesday in April. That's tonight.
Yeah.
Or
it's going to be tonight.
It's going to be tonight when we get there.
Yeah.
Today it's Sunday. Beautiful Sunday.
Yeah. Thank you for joining us. We love thinking about visiting y'all out here in Interweb land.
Interweb land. We're Mr. Jordan, Mr. Tonks. This is William Tonks.
And this is Tommy Jordan.
How do you do?
Yeah. We like playing songs, so we thought we'd do that. But then we got some other things to talk about. And
that first song we played was called Come On In, and that's one of the songs that William wrote. And this is the first half of our first segment called Dos Duets.
Which in American means two duets. But we like Dos Duets.
Dos Duets. Yeah. And so that was the first half of the first segment of the first half of the first segment.
Because we like segments. we're segmented like that. But yeah, this next song was written by
Guy Clark.
Fine Texas singer-songwriter. I guess part of the outlaw movement, you would say. But really, just a kind of straightforward song, but not as straightforward as I thought it was going to be. And it's really fun to play and a beautiful song.
It's called Anyhow I Love You.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3.
You were right.
I was right.
I studied for this test. But yeah, Tommy learned that, giving a guitar lesson to another fella, and played it for me, and I was like, man, we're going to steal that.
Fair and square. We're allowed to. You're allowed to. So, William says he's got something to talk about today during our most popular segment called Conversation.
Conversation.
I don't know if it's our most popular segment. It's certainly one of our segments.
Yes. Well, everybody knows a guitar is a guitar, and a string is a string, and a pick is a pick. Did you know that the real name for pick is plectrum? Well, we use a variety of plectrums. Tommy has ones that he likes. These are triangular shape. We got some custom made Mr. Jordan, Mr. Tonks triangles made of my favorite thickness, green.
But a friend of mine, too.
There's purple ones. I used to like purple, but I'm green and yellow is kind of where
I am. I'm a purple fan myself, a little bit thicker.
A little thicker.
Yeah.
But picks are fun because, you know, a lot of people personalize them, a lot of your favorite rock stars, but also places. So I have a friend named Jim, and Jim was driving along the Blue Ridge Parkway and stopped at the Folk Arts Center up there.
Up in Nashville.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Said it's quite incredible. And he got me a pick.
You gotta throw the focus off.
Well, this rest of the show could be really interesting.
But what's it say on it? You just show the picture.
It's kind of cool. It's just the image.
It's a lonesome pine.
A lonesome pine.
And you know, on the trail of a lonesome pine, that's a bluegrass song. And that's actually a road in Kentucky called Lonesome Pine Trail.
Was it?
It's up near where Loretta Lynn is from.
Did they name the road after the song, or the song after the road?
Which came first? I don't know.
Do you know? Okay, we're tossing this question out. So if anybody wants to, and we will be watching with you Wednesday night, the 14th, in real time, and we can chat. So if anybody has the answer, bring it on.
So what's the question? Which came first?
Which came first?
The Trail of the Lonesome Pine?
Or the song, and they named the trail after it. Like, yeah. Moon River in Savannah didn't always used to be there. It was Jimmy's Creek. But after the song, they thought it fitting to have a Moon River in Savannah. So you can be sailing along and you'll see a little sign and it says Moon River, and they actually have the music scored out on the sign sitting out in the water.
But it's really not much of a river. It's more like a creek.
The river's...
But it's not wider than a mile, you know, and you can cross it in style, that's for sure, someday, but it's not wider than a mile. It's more like 100 feet wide.
But you can sail down it.
You can sail.
So it's at least deep enough for a keelboat. But that's Moon River. That's on the... We need to learn Moon River.
I'd like to.
That's a beautiful song.
It's got words in it that we like.
Yeah. Johnny Mercer wrote him. He was a Savannah guy.
Yes.
Do you know that he was Dave School's uncle?
Had no idea.
Yeah. Widespread Panic's Dave School's. His uncle is Johnny Mercer. So there. Panic fans. All right. So, and the other quick conversational moment, just to show off a chair. Isn't that a nice chair?
It's a nice chair.
I was born in Montclair, New Jersey, moved south when I was 9, but I remember these chairs in the kitchen in Montclair, New Jersey. They moved with us to 112 West Jones Street, 102 West Jones Street, and then ultimately 104 West Jones Street. Then they went to Bundy Park. Then they came here to
Honeycutt
Drive. So,
good chair,
and no arms, which most musicians prefer.
I prefer.
Harmonica players, probably doesn't matter so much.
Probably doesn't matter.
Even a fiddler.
Well, you know, you don't know. Because arms get in the way sometimes, but they're also really comfortable.
Yep.
A place to put your arm. So now, it's time for an instrumental. And at the beginning of each of our shows, we play a little piece of a tune that William wrote called Snow Hill. And today we played it very slowly.
It was Slow Snow.
Yes, Slow Snow, that's right. Today, now what we're going to do is we're going to put a little bit of ice on the hill.
Yeah, for sledding.
For sledding, and we do some ding-a-linging. And but this is the full version of the song. This is called Snow Hill.
1, 2, 3, 4.
was solo.
Thank you. Yeah, there was some. There were. Notes. Watch that one again, folks.
Notes. All right. Well, now you know what? It's time for an intermission. So we will be right back, folks and folkies.
Right back. Intermission. Thank you for rejoining us after that intermission. Hope you found it as enjoyable as we did. We're going to try something different. This is normally the section of the show where we do a solo song. Either Tommy or I, taking turns, will lead a song that the other person may have never heard. They can either sit there and listen or play along. But thanks to a request from the fine McDevitt family in Savannah, Georgia, they reminded us of a practice called the Magic Box. NRBQ, the New Rhythm and Blues Quartet, one of the best bands of all time. If you like Johnny Cash, the Beatles, and Thelonious Monk all mashed up, they're your guys. But they had a segment in the show where they were to allow audience people, members, to put in requests into the Magic Box. So it was suggested that we do an online version of the Magic Box. This is Debbie Tonks.
Hey, Deb.
Hello.
She is the
holder of the Magic Box.
Holder of the Magic Box, but also the collator of suggestions, as we cannot physically put them into the box. So if you want to make a suggestion for a future month, you can email her at debtonks@gmail.com. But we've had a good number of requests this month, so we're going to give it a try. But Debbie came up with an idea. Since NRBQ had the advantage of four or five of them all being singer, could lead a song, so it was really hard to stump those four or five guys. There's just two of us, last I counted. So if we get a request that we absolutely do not know, and there's no faking it, we're going to grab the lifeline and bail, and we'll try again with the promise that we will learn that song that we do not know by next episode.
Yes.
And that would be featured.
Yes.
And so, that seems like a fair,
I
that seems
so.
Like a fair rule. Yeah. You know?
There's a couple tricky ones in here.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, let's see.
Okay.
Drum roll. All right, what do we got, Deb?
Okay. Do you want to read it?
Out of the Magic Box.
Hallelujah, Cut the Strings.
Oh. We know that song.
And it's a wonderful song.
Submitted by Patricia McDevitt.
There we go.
Okay, there we go. Thank you,
Debbie. So we win this time.
Yeah. We win this time. Next time.
There's no telling. Okay, so Tommy's going to talk for a second because it's a different tuning for me and I have to tune.
Well, you know what? I could do the show and tell.
Oh, you could start show and tell. Exactly.
And so... Show and tell this week. I didn't really have something. So wait a minute. Here's the show and tell thing, and we're going to come back to the solo thing. Show and tell. So a couple of years ago, I was in Brazil doing some field work, and one of the field work involved was basically chasing capuchin monkeys around through the savanna down there. It's not called a savanna. I forget what it's called, what the region is called, but it's basically a dry, scrubby landscape with these really kind of steep-sided hills, small mountains called Morro. They're spelled like a Morro, but it's in Portuguese it's Morro. But so these monkeys, these capuchin monkeys, they have this unique behavior for the Western Hemisphere, where they take a rock. And they, which is maybe up to a third of their size, these are not really big monkeys, and they use it as a hammer against an anvil
which is could be a piece of a log or another rock on the bottom, and they use it to crack these date palms. They're like palm nuts that are kind of, the internal structure is like a walnut. So they've got all, they're really hard to crack, but they've got really, I wonder, I guess, delicious meat on the inside. So they use this hammer and this anvil, and they go bam, 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 and they break the nuts and they eat it. And then they also teach the behavior to their young. And they pass it on from generation to generation, and they use the same hammer stones and anvil stones from year to year. Well, so I took a video of it and I put it up on YouTube. And fall before last, I noticed it was getting a lot of hits. In fact, it had over 3 million hits. And I had some like 8,000 followers on YouTube. And who knew that? Because I just put out music videos, which, you know, sometimes get 130 views. they're not the most popular in the world. But they're all high quality, just for the record. So I decided I would monetize this thing. And over the course of 3 months, I made over $600 on YouTube. And so what I did is I used that money to buy some cowboy boots. And here they are. This is one of them. We call them my monkey boots. I don't know if you can even see it, but they're beautiful suede. They're Tecovas. They're Texas boots, as seen on Facebook. And they're beautiful. And so they're my monkey boots. And I'm very, very proud of my monkey boots.
Yep. And I was quite relieved when I started hearing about the monkey boots to realize they're not actually made of monkey. They are just monkey motivated.
Funded. Monkey funded? Monkey funded? Yeah.
A monkey motivation.
Yeah. But anyway, monkey boots are the way to go these days, people. And so actually, since COVID hit, the primary viewership of this video, it turns out, was Indian, from the country of India, men ages 23 to 35. Who knows why that is, but it's also very popular in Thailand and in Southeast Asia. But thank you all, oh, people over there, for my monkey boots. I'm very happy to have good cowboy boots because I've never had good cowboy boots before.
And as a nice tie into that, if you've ever seen the Twilight Zone movie, based obviously on Twilight Zone episodes, in the beginning, John Lithgow and somebody else are in a scene where they're driving down the road, and one's a hitchhiker and one just gave the other guy a ride. And they're quizzing each other on TV show songs. And they go back and forth 3 or 4 times, and who, call it, John says, "What about this one? Da 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 da." And the guy's like, "Ah, it sounds familiar, I'm not sure." He says, so John Lithgow goes, "I am a monkey and I use a stone for a tool."
Really?
And he goes, "National Geographic." And that was it.
Well, he even had a British accent. "And I am a monkey and I use a stone for a tool."
So
this is Hallelujah.
The magic box has provided. This is a song that we like a lot.
Remind me the key.
D.
D, a key of D, thank you.
Formed by Fairground Attraction. I learned it from a friend, Eileen Healy, who came over from the Emerald Isle to Athens, Georgia for a while and played a show with Horse Feathers, a band I was in at the time, with George Norman and Akiye Igarashi. Anyway, we had a great time playing, and this is that song.
Hallelujah.
1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Lights on the west wing go on. Million cars hurry home. Ice cream man shuts off his tinsel bell. Winter won't be long. I see you every day. Watch as you walk down my way. Pass on the stairs of the council bluff. Try to find words to say.
but your smile's a prayer. Praise the love and your heart's a kite. Long to fly. Hallelujah, here I am. Cut the strings tonight. So meet me on the corner at 8. Let's get out of this place. We'll kiss the first of a million kisses. Let the past roll away. Oh, but your smile is a prayer. Here I am. Cut the strings tonight. Get out of this place. We'll kiss the first of a million kisses. Let the past roll away. Offer a smile as prayer.
Magic Box. You know, William, that what? Song has got one of my very favorite lines in it. The one about, we'll kiss the first of a million kisses.
Yeah.
What a wonderful sentiment that is.
Yeah.
I just love that.
It just kind of makes you look forward to the future.
It does indeed.
Yeah.
It does indeed.
I'm fine with the past and I try to be in the present, but it's nice to have something to look forward to.
Well, if you look forward to a million more kisses, hell yeah.
I'd even settle for 999,999.
Would you?
But I'd take a million.
You'd take a million, yeah. So now it is time for our third, well, it's actually technically tonight, it's our fourth duet. And for our selection tonight, we have chosen a song that I learned off of. There was an album that came out, it was some years ago, I don't remember when it was, called The New Basement Tapes. And what it was an album of lyrics that Bob Dylan wrote that other people put to music. And it was one of those things that NPR calls driveway moments, where I was listening to it on NPR and I was so taken by it. I listened to the entire story before, when I got home from work, and I went in immediately and ordered the record because it was so good. And one of my favorite songs,
Motivation.
Motivation. So this song is called Diamond Ring, and so the words were by Bob Dylan, but the music is by a fella named Taylor Goldsmith, who plays and sings with a band called Dawes. And this is a fun song.
It's kind of interesting because, you know, Dylan tells a story in a certain way, but he tends to write in a certain, well, in a lot of certain ways. But but this guy doesn't write like Bob Dylan. So it's a whole different kind of feel for a Bob Dylan kind of story.
Yeah. We've taken it and turned it into a Mr. Jordan, Mr. Tonks kind of feel. Let's have enough volume be heard there, my friend.
Hit you?
What do you think, people?
Sounds about right. That's a very, very, it's a canon. In guitar parlance, a Martin D41 is a canon.
Yeah, this is a...
Shout out, tip of the cap, to Stephen Stills. So those of you who may not know this, in the late 60s, early 70s, people thought new guitars were the way to go. And it was Steve Stills in the rock community that kind of figured, hey man, those old guitars were actually really good. And he started looking into Martins and D28s and 35s, but CSNY would also often appear on stage with D45s, which is very much close to this guitar. And it's just these great Martins, well, there's a reason people call them great. And the reason
and
is
what is that?
Because they're great.
That's
there.
The reason.
We summed that up pretty well.
And those of you who know me, who know that I love me a good Martin guitar. This is my D41. This is actually my very first Martin guitar. And it's still my go-to guitar.
If you had to pick one,
this might be it. I can't pick one though.
He's got
don't
couple,
make me pick
he's
one.
He's got two or three more choices now. Yeah. So.
Yeah, don't make me pick one. Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four. Gold, behold that diamond ring.
up to the law. And I'm gonna marry the one I love and move back to Cleveland. Diamond ring, diamond ring, shine like gold, behold that diamond ring.
No. So that
like
was
that.
Supposed to be that was supposed to be a
glissando or glycerindo,
a glissupto or glissdando
or a innuendo.
Yeah. So we have these little like, you know, audibles. They're not audible. They're ups and downs. So a lot of these songs, not a lot of the songs, but enough of our songs have got little or things like that. And so we like to kind of, you know, it doesn't matter which way you go sometimes. And so
call it on the fly.
Call it on the fly.
We do not rehearse every single thing. We are often
of the moment.
Improvising. And good. And, you know, good to try stuff, you know. I'd hate to play everything the same way every time. And
true.
There's no worry of that.
Yeah. Well, okay, so people... Thank you for tuning in tonight. This is the
April episode
number, I'm not sure which, six now or five something.
Of Second Wednesday,
Mr. Wednesday with Mr. Jordan, Mr. Tonks.
We appreciate you taking the time to spend with us. Keep those calls and letters coming if you got questions, comments, requests. Remember debtonks@gmail.com is where you send those magic box requests.
That's right. And she's always willing to accept emails about the magic box. And this week, you know, we got lucky. We got a song that we know, because you're allowed to request songs that you haven't heard us play, that you know we know. But you're also allowed to play Stump the Chump. And the new rule is
if we're totally stumped that we can't even play a mediocre version of that song, which we'd be proud of, we will learn it well by the next month. So that's actually, all of a sudden, we have a chance to broaden our repertoire,
which is always good.
It's always good.
Next month, Mr. Wednesday will be on May 11th, and I hope you'll tune in for that. We'll give you fair warning.
That'd be the 5-1-1.
5-1-1.
But we have a good night song, a going away, see you next time song. Tommy's going to take us through this song.
I'm back in the saddle again, about where a friend is a friend, where we sleep out every night and the only law is right. Back in the saddle. Ride in the range once more, towed in my old 44, where we sleep out every night and the only one's right. Back in the saddle again. Whoopee-tie-yi-yo, rocking through and through. Back in the saddle again. Whoopee-tie-yi-yo. Thank you.
So long, saddle pals.
We'll see you next time.
When you walk around and see other animals, you can recognize them by the tips. Rain doesn't get tips like that. Or, you know, just generally raisin doesn't get tips like that.
What if they want to just hide big ones? Can we see if she has a little bit of a defensive side? Can they be attacking from the right? Although they had the chance to cool that tip rather than the left side, they walk there.
Batteries.
They choose to look to the other side.